And good morning, boys and girls. It's Saturday the 18th of May 2013. A warm welcome along to today's United Kingdom talk. What's wrong with you this morning?
I thought it was live.
It is live.
What, live tomorrow?
No, it's live Friday, but we're recording Saturday's show. Look, immediately we start, there's something wrong.
What's wrong?
Can you see the things going round all slowly?
What things?
Oh, I don't know. Well, good morning. Morning, morning. I've got my friend here today. Ron's here. Come say hello.
Hello.
Come say hello, look, Ron.
No, I will say hello before I leave.
Don't be shy. Come in.
No,
come
I'm
in
not,
for
no,
the picture.
No, it's fine. I can just give my comments and views as we carry on.
But they want to see your pretty boy face.
They just want to see the hand.
There is someone here in the studio with me today. Can I just say, those of you that watched the show last week, you might have noticed the sound wasn't quite up to scratch. That was simply because there was two of us in here, and one was further from the mic. The closer I get to the mic, you see, the better it sounds. Do you know what I mean? If I move far away, it's not so good. If I move close, it's more booming and bassful. There we are. So that's the reason for that, boys and girls. You can, of course, contact us. Once again, we're recording Saturday's show. If it's Friday morning and it's just coming up to 25 minutes to 11, then you are indeed watching the show live. And there is at least 1 million of you at the moment. It's 1 million.
No, one. We've had this conversation before.
Are you sure?
I'm absolutely positive. And that one viewer is probably yourself.
I don't think
at this present time.
I don't think it is one.
I'm sure it's one.
I'm sure it's not. I wonder who that one person is. It can't be me, can it? Just a moment. No, it's not me, I'm glad to say, because I've shut that part of it down.
Right, okay. Cool. Well, you never know. Numbers might
I'm
increase.
I'm sure that's 1 million.
No, it's not. We've had this conversation before about all the noughts that would normally come after 1 million. 900,000,
yeah, but they wouldn't put all the noughts on there to save space on the text.
Oh, they would. They would.
Do you think so?
Yes, absolutely.
I'm not so sure.
Now I've rained all over your parade. Carry on.
Go on, sing it. Barbara Streisand.
Do you know, she's a second cousin of a second cousin of my dad. No, seriously, she is.
Come in.
She's one.
Well, can we get her into the studio? Would she come here?
She doesn't. Do you know what she doesn't do?
We've had Nikki French in this studio.
Yeah,
Nikki French from the Eurovision Song Contest.
Barbara Streisand, she very rarely does interviews and shows now.
Come into the
She is a prime target for Al-Qaeda. Did you know that? Because she is a formidable Jewish woman.
Right.
That promotes, you know, Jewish things, and they don't like that.
Is that because of the nose?
No,
it's nothing
to do with the nose, because if it was, then
but
it'd be
I've got a large nose, and I'm not Jewish, Roman Catholic, dear. Do we have large noses as well?
I don't know.
Or just deep pockets?
Roman Catholics do like to poke their nose into other people's business all the time, don't
we? We certainly don't, dear.
Certainly don't.
Is this a religious programme today?
No, it's not religious.
Where's Thora Heard? Are you... Thora Heard,
she's
are
dead.
You here?
She's dead.
Oh, yes, who's the boy? I'm walking on the air. He does it now, doesn't he?
Oh, does he? I don't know. I don't watch that programme.
Alid Jones. That's it. Alid Jones from Daybroke.
Oh, I've never watched that.
Daybroke. No, no.
Never watched that.
Now, as I was saying yesterday, the sound wasn't so good last week because James was sitting a little bit far away from the microphone. It's very difficult to tell unless you've actually got headphones on. I suppose I could check now, really, couldn't I?
Well, there's no point in doing it now. You should have done all these checks before. I bet they don't do this at the BBC.
No, of course they don't do this at the BBC because there's about 10 people standing around doing nothing. Here, it's me and you. Me and you. All... More of us. I hope you don't mind me using that term, boys and girls. Us. As in you and me. And you as well today.
Yeah.
So it might sound a little bit echoey today as well, because Ron's sitting with us here at the same time. There we are. Now, you can contact the show at any time, either by using Skype. Again, that's if you're with us Friday morning. Then use... I don't know why that picture's not so good today. I wonder if there's a little adjustment I can do. Just a moment now. Because I'm not quite happy with that. Advanced settings. Something's not quite right. I think it might be that. Possibly that. Would you like to shave your changes? Go on,
Oh, you look like you've got jaundice now.
I have got jaundice, thank you. It's liver failure. We are speaking to you this morning with liver failure, boys and girls. No, that's not going to work, is it?
No, you need to put it back to where it was.
Is that better? No, that's completely mucked it up now, isn't it? Never mind. Put that one on there.
Yeah, just leave it as it was. Why are you playing about with it?
Save the settings. There we are. A little bit more of a white face. Not that that's a racial thing. I don't think there's anything wrong with having a bit of a yellow face, to be honest. In fact, I think I was Chinese in the last life.
Oh.
But not this life, because I can't eat the food. No. We can't eat Chinese food. Right, now, I'd like to introduce you to my best friend today, Ron, who will now come into the picture. Come on, that's it. I'll move aside for you. And it's gone all out of focus now. Look, how have you done that? You've made me all out of focus. Look, we can adjust that. I don't have any of these problems when you're not here.
Could you just move over, just a touch? I know you've got big hips and everything, but...
I've just realised there's a bit of a problem now.
Yeah, you need to...
Because that's in the way.
That's better.
So we'll put that back up there like that.
I'm not staying long. I've only come to give 10 minutes of my opinions.
You stay as long as you
want.
2 minutes. Why not stay 2 whole minutes? And that's got to face you like that, you see.
Why has it got to face me?
So that millions of people, the 1 million people, can hear you.
There's not 1 million.
There is 1 million.
There's not 1 million.
There is.
There's not.
I keep telling you there's 1 million. Right, so you keep going on. What do you want to talk about then? Because you don't want to talk about anything inane. I've got emails here. Can you read or read an email?
I can read, yes.
I like your little flick on your hair.
Yeah, I'm having it cut in about an hour.
How do you keep that going one way? He does this sort of thing with his head like that. Go on, do it.
You obviously can't.
Do it.
You obviously can't do that. Cats running. Now we've spoke about this.
We spoke about
viewers.
What?
We spoke about this before, about the stuff that Chris actually talks about. And I have to be honest with you, some of it is absolute downright rubbish. I mean, you know, he worries about listener of numbers, but he doesn't talk about things that are in the news. So I'd like you to write in and tell Chris about things in the news that he could discuss with you to get his numbers up. Because you keep going about this 1 million.
There is 1 million.
There's not 1 million.
It says it there. 1 million people are watching this morning.
No. Not at all.
Hey?
Not at all. Anyway, why don't we ask Steve Allen for advice?
Steve Allen, my friend.
Well, yeah.
He didn't even remember your name. Steve Allen's a guy on LBC, and we bumped into him. Remember I told you?
You never introduced me, that's why. He didn't ask.
The Mullins Garden Centre.
He didn't ask my name.
And, he didn't seem to remember. And then we got a mention on his show.
No, you did.
But well, I got the mention.
Yeah, but
and he didn't know.
That's because you've been stalking him.
I haven't been stalking. What, hanging around garden centres?
Hanging around garden centres and emailing him and calling him at LBC.
Talking of garden centres, I have spent an absolute fortune this year so far in a garden centre, haven't we? We both have, really, in garden centres this year. So that's it. No more visits to garden centres unless absolutely necessary, you know. We might have sort of an emergency. Something like that where...
An emergency.
For example, you could go home now and find one of your hanging baskets has collapsed off the wall and onto the floor. That would be an emergency.
Well, then that would be your fault because you put them up and you would be replacing them.
But that wouldn't you class that as an emergency?
I would,
then have to rush down to the garden centre to get a replacement hanging basket.
Yeah, because my garden is very symmetrical. As you look down the garden, there is
three hanging
baskets.
It's just that it was done.
I've just had it all done. It looks absolutely beautiful. I have fairy lights all the way around.
Tell them what you've done.
I've had new
lawn. What was it like when you moved in there?
It was very
unlandscaped.
It was all right,
wasn't it?
No, it wasn't. It was awful.
No, it was all right.
It was awful.
It was all right.
No, it wasn't. It was awful. All right for you is awful for me.
Go on.
What happened there? Is that your Tourette's coming out?
Yes, it is.
Oh, I'm sorry. It was very bad. I'm not flicking. Keep flicking my hair.
Go on, do it.
I'm going to have it cut in about... An hour is going to be cut.
Can you just be careful? You're going in front of the Barry Manilow picture.
Oh, God. What was I saying about the garden?
Exactly.
Yeah, it was in a terrible state. It was in a terrible state. It's now been re-turfed. There's hanging baskets, new shed, new fence. And soon the shutters are going up over the patio doors and it's going to be
absolute... What shutters?
Shutters. I've ordered shutters.
You haven't?
I have, yes.
I thought you weren't going to get those.
Well, I've ordered them.
I was round there the other day and this man came and quoted for shutters. How much did he want?
£1,000.
£1,000? £1,000. That's about $1,700, okay, for 2 wooden shutters.
No, it's not. It's not for 2 wooden shutters.
What is it then?
It's for 6 shutters that fold across the doors.
For 1 window. Not window. It's not the whole house.
Patio doors.
One bloody
patio
window.
Patio doors.
Shutters. Patio
2 metre squared patio doors. and they're handmade.
Handmade shutters. Yes. From China.
Yes.
From China. Don't even make them here.
No, that's not my fault.
They should. How do you know they're not made out of sustainable wood?
They are. It says it in the brochure.
From sustainable forests.
It says it in the brochure.
What brochure?
The brochure that
it
they
doesn't. It always says it made in China.
No, it doesn't.
You know, someone's made those shutters for about gets 1 pence a week, and they sit and it's they sleep 10 people.
They're
10 people.
They're
in
not
the
working for Apple.
Awful, dear. Awful.
And did you know that Apple is now voted one of the best high street shops on the high street?
Is it?
Yes, and W.H. Smith has come in last.
Yeah, well, I'm not.
W.H. Smith has come in last, and that's quite strange because now the post office are in most of the W.H. It's not somewhere that I frequent often.
What, the post office?
Yep, a lot of them are in W.H.
Well,
Smith
how do you
now.
Post your letters then?
Because they're
where
closed.
Where do you go? Somewhere else? Does someone collect them from you and take
no,
them down
No, you post them.
I know you're a postman. I know you're that postman. You go in and post your letters because you take it. Because I went in the same one the other day because I went in there with my letter and you give it to him. Oh, I'd like to consent that first bloke. Oh, what's in there then? Yeah. Nosy old bastard.
Nosy
old
language.
Bastard.
Language.
Oh, it's all right. You just certain words are okay.
Oh, okay.
It's just not very strong words.
Right. Okay. But he is very nosy. He is very nosy.
Do you tell him? Or do you give him a glare?
No, what I did, last time I took a box in there and he asked what it was, I told him it was sex toys.
Oh, God's sake. What did he say?
Well, he didn't say, couldn't say very much, really, did he? And then there's the woman in there with the plastic arm.
What woman? Well, she's probably, that's not nice.
No, but I'm just saying she's got the plastic, no, I'm not taking the mick out of her, she's got the plastic arm. It's very, it's wonderful how she licks the stamps, does the stamps.
How does she lick the stamps then?
Well, she takes the arm off, does that at the end and then sticks it to the stamp and brings it up and does it like that and puts it on the stamp. It's really funny with this hand.
So what happens to her arm?
Well, she's got nothing there. It's like that.
Well, it's not something to take the mick out.
I'm not taking the mick out of it. She's very clever the way that she does it.
I'd like to see you in a wheelchair and push you around. I'm looking forward to that day when I can do that.
You won't be doing that.
Little thing in Waitrose, do you?
Oh, I like Waitrose.
Oh, let me talk. Wait till we get to that. Wait till we get to that. Go back to the post office. Come back. Come back to the post office.
I'm just saying, the post office, a lot of the post offices are now in W.H. Smith. And, you know, they've had their revenues.
In Bracknell, surely. So what in Bracknell?
No, because the main post office is still open. But a lot of the smaller ones are now closed and obviously have been integrated into places like W.H. Smith. And it's horrendous. You have to walk through this whole books and things. You know, it's just another way of marketing them, making people buy stuff, but it's backfired because people aren't. Their sales have dropped.
So that's last in a what? Survey of what?
In a high street survey.
When I've gone in, certainly the W.H. Smith, I've noticed over the last few years, it's become more and more messy in there.
Oh, absolutely.
It's
untidy.
It's difficult to navigate. I'm the same, navigating my way without a bloody sat nav. But you need a sat nav now to go into W.H. Smith. You can't navigate your way around.
I like shops that are very organised and very well set out, like Waitrose, like John Lewis.
And then there's all the people that, if you think you're going there, I want to get a magazine. You can't get to the magazines because they're standing there reading them all.
Of course they are. People are like library. This. Like
they think it's a bloody library, dear. Yep. A library. Look at the people, not me. Look at the people.
Well, I'm talking to you.
Look, 1 million people. That's
one viewer.
Doesn't seem to have moved that, does it, at all?
No.
Get on with it, then.
No, you were interfering with my flow of my flow. But Apple has been obviously voted the best shop on the high street.
I have been in Apple.
Apple is a very good store. The staff are very, very helpful. Their products are second to none.
They're just a bit expensive.
No, I don't think they are for what you get. No,
this is one of those iPad 2
okay,
things.
So an iPad. You look at an iPad, £400. But you just plug it in and it works. Everything works. You don't have issues with Windows and all of this.
What,
look at this malarkey
iPhone?
That
like
you've got
iPhone.
Here. Look at this malarkey that you've got here. All wires and, you know, it's just ridiculous. Whereas with this, it's just easy.
I hope you're not suggesting for one moment we could just do a show on this.
Oh, of course you could.
Do you know, we could actually.
Actually, you
Shall
could.
Shall I show
exactly.
you how easy that is?
No, I don't wish to see. No.
I'm going to show
One
you
One show a day
Shut up, woman.
Is more than enough.
I'm going to show you now. Watch. Right? So, as well as going on YouTube, we can go on Ustream. We used to go on Ustream, don't anymore, because... It costs money, doesn't it? No, it kept...
It costs money. That's what it comes down to.
No.
Cost.
No. It kept throwing up ads all the time.
Throwing up?
ads. So, and the way it would work, so you'd be, we'd be doing a show now.
Could you not pay for the ads?
Can I explain?
But can you not
pay for... explain? Right?
See, that's physical abuse.
Can I explain?
On camera, physical abuse.
And recorded as well. If I can explain. So we'd be doing a show like this, and all of a sudden, with no warning at all from either my point of view or the viewer's point of view, it would cut away to an ad.
A bit like on Facebook when you're advertising your shows.
And then it would come back, right? Unannounced. So you wouldn't know where it left and where it joined. And not only that, it doesn't pause you and then go to an ad and come back. The people watching lose that bit. So we could be into something very, very important. And as you know, all the subjects of in my show are world-changing opinions. What is that in your ear? I love this. He's got hearing aids. Do that thing where you make it...
No, don't start embarrassing me now. Don't start embarrassing me now, because that's awful to embarrass somebody. That's not nice.
Well, you're going on about plastic arms.
That's different.
It's not different at all. Make it whistle. Go on.
No.
Go on, do it.
No,
come to the mic.
No.
He does that thing like that and it whistles.
That's not nice. I have sensory issues.
Sensory issues. And I've never heard so much crap in all my life.
You've got issues as well.
I've got no issues. No issues
you
at all.
You have got plenty of issues.
Right, so you can actually do a show
from
Ustream. Watch.
Mind you don't press the wrong button.
There's a U... Just see what icons are on there. There's a Ustream app, which is that one there. It's a little Ustream app. You simply push it like that, okay? It says Ustream.
I know, we've been through this.
Camera, go live. Okay, go live, like that. Choose United Kingdom talk. And it says connecting, measuring bandwidth. Right, measuring bandwidth like that. Watch this. You'll love this. It's so simple.
Yes, it's done.
Share your board and push the red button.
Knock everything over.
And we are now on air.
No, because you've got the camera facing the wrong way around.
Oh, I don't know if you can change the camera on this. While it's... Oh, I don't think you can. 1 minute, let's stop. Cancel. Okay. So how do we turn the camera? We can't... There it is. Look, turn the camera around.
There we go.
Right.
Oh, marvellous. Now press the red button again.
Press the red button. There and now we're on Ustream as well. It's a little bit... Why is that misty like that?
Because you've got something over the lens. No, if you look at the thing, it hasn't.
Oh, it hasn't got a hole in it.
Oh no, that's the camera.
Have you got a pin?
No.
Maybe it's just dirty. So there we are. Now we're on Ustream as well. How clever is that?
That is very clever. Very, very clever indeed.
Right. So you were talking about, but the only thing is, if someone calls in, they wouldn't be able to hear that now.
No.
Do you see what I mean?
Yeah, I do see what you mean. Now, where was I? I was talking about...
He was going on about the post office.
Yeah, just a moment. I'm just going to update myself.
Are you going
that.
Soon?
I am going soon. Where's it gone now? Yeah.
Oh, have you made notes there as well?
No, I haven't.
Oh. Always made notes. How lovely to be prepared.
Messy and expensive. That's how it's been labelled. Messy and expensive. I think we've been through
and
that.
Who's saying this? If you read something out of the newspaper, you have to quote the name of the newspaper so that they get the
It's the
Mail
the
online.
Line, the Mail
Thank
online.
You. The Daily Mail.
Daily Mail.
Thank you.
Thank you. And the other thing that I wanted to talk about that you can put in your summary so you get more listeners is the problem with the fuel at the moment. The cost of fuel and how motorists have been ripped off for 10 years.
Well, we know that,
they've been saying it and saying it and saying it. And they called it a limp-wristed lettuce leaf approach that the Department for... what's it called now? The department, you know, that checks things. What are they called?
Yes.
Is it off something? Anyway, they checked the price and they called it a limp-wristed lettuce leaf.
Okay.
Investigation, which it was, because we are being continually ripped off at the petrol pumps. As
well,
you well know,
it's been going on for years.
I mean, you know, and
You want to see how much I? Well, actually, you know, I don't. I've managed to cut down on my petrol, as you know, or diesel, petrol, whatever, simply for the way I drive.
We'll start hitchhiking. On the M3, I can just imagine you hitchhiking with your laptop.
I might be picked up by one of those nasty big butch big butch
lorry drive straight past you. They drive straight past you. Everybody would just drive straight past you. It's
very disappointing.
You look like a vagrant. Could we not have put a nice shirt on today?
There's nothing wrong with this jumper.
This hideous man-made
fibre. Look, it's Lee.
Yeah, I'm getting a rash on my hand because I've just touched it.
I've got to tell you, he bought me a couple of woolen jumpers.
Beautiful. Let's get it right. Lamb's wool jumpers.
Lamb's wool jumpers from wherever. And I became aware that I was getting... Because you saw it yourself. It was all like scaly skin. And I'm allergic to lamb's wool.
Lizard.
Oh.
Lizard.
Wasn't that a birthday present? It
was a birthday present that he had to give back to me. And I've been looking for something ever since. Oh. So I will try and find something on one of my next trips. So I've got Ireland, Vegas, and Rome. Of course
it's not your fault that it was its ear. So.
It's your fault. You can't have anything natural or nice, can you?
No.
It's quite funny that, isn't it?
No. It's all false. Yes. Even my friends.
Even you.
Anyway, going back to your petrol prices, I did find a little thing on the internet here in the newspapers this morning. Here we are. Petrol sharks pile on agony for drivers. So we've already had this story here in the UK about BP and Shell saying that they're colluding to keep the prices high. And what surprises me, there's no mention anywhere of how much the government take. Because is it like 60 pence out of every pound?
It's the government, the actual price of a litre of fuel is about 45 pence. So they're taking around 90 pence in two different types of taxes. We've got VAT and fuel duty. So that amounts to probably 2/3 of how much a litre of fuel is. Now, the thing is with the petroleum companies. I mean, look at BP, multinational company, but they've now gone to David Cameron and asked him to speak to the people about the compensation that they're giving out in regards to their spill in the US. I mean, you know, they're ripping us off in one hand, and then they're trying to limit the amount of compensation they give because they absolutely, you know, tortured the wildlife and the people, you know, on the coast of America that were so badly hit by the spill. It's just wrong. You know, but they don't arrest these people. They invite them to Parliament, to a parliamentary committee, to speak to them. It's ridiculous. If it was a normal, everyday person that was ripping someone off like that, they would be arrested. It's the same as the Rupert Murdoch scandal. Exactly the same thing. They didn't arrest him. They invited him to Parliament.
Well, that's because they're all in each other's pockets.
Of course they are. It's an absolute disgrace. The other thing is who's going to be compensated over this? If they're found to have been doing this, the investigators will fine them and the money will then go to the government. But it won't come back to us in a reduced fuel duty.
I saw somewhere something about that.
It's awful. It's
large companies are going to be able to get all their bills together and get something back for this if what they're planning at the moment all goes through. Now, we also will be able to do to that, right? But you will need to prove to the petrol people that you bought the petrol from them, which for me is actually quite easy.
Yeah.
Because I keep being self-employed if I wanted to. But can you just imagine the time it would take for you to do that?
Absolutely.
Right? So it wouldn't be... If it would be a case of just printing out my accounts and sending it... Right, well, this is what I've bought of you. And it says, I mean, I could bring up your accounts now. BP, £52. BP, Shell, so and so. I could just print that out fairly quickly. It would take me 20 minutes.
Yeah.
In an hour, I could print you off all the money I've spent on petrol in the last 10 years.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just one print off and all it would have a bit, and it would tell you which stations.
But
they would want the receipts as well. Now, here are my receipts for May, right? In there will be a petrol's receipts. As it happens, it's the one. There's one on top there, right? One there. Another one there, okay? So that's May. Now, I would have to dig out...
10 years.
10 years worth of these. So I'd have to dig out... What?
So that's 120 boxes.
That's 12 times... That's 120 boxes. 120 envelopes. And I'd have to take each one out
And go
through the thing. Not only that, if... Because sometimes if you get a tax inspection, which is a different subject, but would be involved in this...
Yep.
the tax people can at any time say, okay, we want to look at your accounts for the last 5 years.
Yeah.
Right. Now, so, after I've got all these petrol receipts out, and you know they're going to say, we want the originals.
Of course.
You just know that.
Yeah.
Right? After they've said that, so they've sent them all off, right? What happens if the tax people then say, okay, we'd like to look at, oh, you, I haven't got my petrol accounts. Oh, really? They would say.
Yep.
And then you would have to pay more to the tax people, so it's like a double-edged sword.
It's actually not as easy as that. Yeah, what they need to do is whatever money they fine these companies, if they have been found to be doing this, should be used to lower the fuel duty for a period of time so that people, you know, obviously get some of their money back.
Yeah.
You know, it's just awful. But we are being ripped off left, right and centre because they are all in each other's pockets. That's why I believe that this radical UKIP company that have come in will do something good. I mean, at the end of the day, they call them fruitcakes and racists. And at the end of the day, they're no worse than what's in power already because they're all closet racists and fruitcakes anyway.
You reckon they're all the same?
Of course they are. Yeah. They're all the same, all in power at the moment. But Nick Farage is different. He is totally different. He's got a different way of looking at things, and I think that's what this country needs. And it needs somebody that isn't in the pockets of the people that are already in power.
Do we know enough about UKIP? Do we actually know enough? All we really know is this one thing that he's got with coming out of Europe. And let me put my flag says we come out of Europe.
Yeah.
As does yours.
Yes.
As does his.
Yes.
Okay, so fair enough.
You're talking about his other policies.
We don't really know what his other policies are. One of his policies, and I know you'll agree with this, but I don't, is the wind farms. He wants to stop the wind farms being built.
Yeah.
Right?
It's a blight on the landscape. Absolutely awful.
Yeah, yeah. When I see these wind turbines, and of course there isn't one near me, right? I cannot see or hear a wind turbine around me. But when I see them in places, I kind of think to myself that they're not particularly ugly. They look all right to me.
Completely.
What I mean? They don't. To me, I look at them and I think they're quite nice, just like a modern version of a windmill.
Not really.
Yeah. You don't like them, right? Agreed. That one of the things we could do, as is what's happening now, is put them out in the sea. Right, way out in the sea where you wouldn't be able to see them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's a possibility.
We have a caller.
Do we have a caller? Oh, yes, so we do. Just a moment. Oh, we've missed it. 1 minute. Let's try it again.
Well, I do actually have to leave now because it's 11 o'clock.
Oh, surely not. You must have a few moments to talk to Dave on the Isle of Wight. I don't think it's working, though. Let's see if we can get to Dave.
What a funny picture of you on there.
What? What's wrong with that picture?
You look like you've got sunburn.
That's a red light, that is.
What was you doing in a red light district?
I don't go in red light districts, I?
Well, you just said you was under a red light.
There's no red light districts, thank you. Come on, David, answer the blooming phone. David, where are you? Well, he'd be doing something now. He's in the background. Never mind, we can't get that.
Well, thank you for letting me say my piece on your hobby today. On your hobby today.
Are you going already?
Yeah,
good.
I do enjoy you having your little hobby. It's, you know, it keeps you quiet.
Hobby? This is a trans-global television programme. How can you call it a
started hobby? As an interest, and then when it started to cost you money, it became a hobby. Yeah,
what money has this cost me this week?
Thank you, viewers. It's been very nice.
Are you leaving soon? Good.
Viewer. Thank you, viewer.
1 million.
One million. Viewer. One must go. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Been wonderful to see you. Can you take the cups down with you as well? Can you wash them up before you go?
No, I can't.
Have you got your keys?
No.
You're not leaving that door on the jar, are you?
No, what I'll do is I'll lock it and post the keys back through the letterbox.
There's a voice message from David.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye. What a shame I'm being left on my own just to talk, boys and girls. I'm left alone again. Left alone. There we are, my friend Ron. He has very strong opinions about this, that and the other, quite often. Now, you can contact the show, as I say, boys and girls. If it's a Friday morning and it's 11 o'clock, then you are with us live. You can contact us by using Skype. The Skype username is Chris Reardon, all one word, C-H-R-I-S. R-E-A-R-D-O-N. Chris Reardon is the Skype username. If you'd like to phone in, we have a local London number. The phone number is 020-8133-6358. Okay? 020-8133-6358. All right? They're the two contact methods. If you're watching a recording of the show, then you can, as always, write in on the email, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. And we should have... is that you?
Is that me?
Oh, that's all right. He's just locked the door, young Ron. Ron's left now. You've just missed him.
Oh, no.
Did you move away from the computer there or something?
Did I what?
Well, when I rung you back, I couldn't get hold of you.
I don't know what was going on. My computer's running slow.
Oh, not to worry. Well, we're talking to Dave on the Isle of Wight. And, if I'm right, Charlie is in the background as well.
And Charlie, yeah.
Hello, Dave.
He's not actually in the background. He's right up here with me.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
It's nice to talk to you, Dave. It's been a while, isn't it?
It has, isn't it? Yeah.
Hello, it's been Chris.
Is that Charlie?
That's Charlie, yeah.
Oh, yeah. You've just melted my art. You've
you
absolutely just
swimming.
Melted my art. That was wonderful. Hello, Charlie. How old are you?
He's three, aren't you?
I'm three.
You're 3 years old? Hello? This is the first time I've spoke to you. Is it 3 years? I can't believe that.
Yeah.
My word. Charlie, I was doing the show once... And your mummy, yeah, and your mummy and daddy rung me while you were just a few days old.
Yeah. We've named the other one. It's going to be Harry.
Harry. Now it's funny you should say that. Well, I'll come to that in a minute.
Harry.
Pardon?
Harry. You got Harry, little brother coming, didn't you?
Yeah.
Little brother Harry.
Yeah. How did you get Ron on webcam then?
Oh, it was hard work. Well, he just appeared this morning.
Oh.
I was downstairs making the tea and suddenly it walks in.
Oh.
Just walks in because it's got a set of keys.
Hello,
and it's
Chris.
Walked in. But yeah, he's gone now. He's got something to do today. He's going having his hair cut or something like that.
Yeah, he needs it, doesn't he?
Yeah, it's a bit long at the front. Unlike mine, I had mine cut yesterday. You might have noticed I've had a number half all over. I was a bit concerned. It's a little bit drastic. A couple of people have told me they think I should completely shave it all off and be done with it.
You see, I have a grade two and I do it myself.
You have a number two, but you don't have a bald spot in the middle, do you?
Yeah.
Oh, you do as well?
Yeah.
Okay, well, the longer it is, the more obvious the bald spot becomes. That's the problem.
Yeah. Will you sit on my knee and behave yourself?
That one.
What? What one?
That one.
Which one? Oh, you want that knee? All right, I've got that knee then.
What's your favourite food, Charlie? What do you like eating?
What's your favourite food? Charlie.
Chocolate. Is it going to be chocolate?
What's, no. That's for me. What's your favourite food?
Jacket potatoes.
He likes jacket potatoes.
Jacket potatoes. I like those with baked beans and maybe cheese.
She can wait.
I like with a baked bean. I like to have baked beans overdone. Do you know what I mean by that, Dave?
Yeah.
You know when they start going a little bit more sticky and congealed? That's how I like my baked beans.
Oh, okay. I heard you've seen the new Star Trek.
I have seen the new Star Trek, yes, last week. Oh, it was good. It was really good.
Out of 10, what do you think?
Out of 10, I thought it was really good. I didn't think it was quite as good as the first one. But nevertheless, so if I gave the first one 10, I would give this one 9.
Oh.
What about you?
No.
I don't know, I haven't seen it yet.
But my heart jumped when Spock suddenly appeared on the screen, because I didn't expect that.
Which one?
Spock.
What, the old Spock?
Yeah.
So he's in the new film as
well? Oh, have you not seen it yet?
No, I haven't seen
it.
Oh,
well, why didn't you bloody well say that? Now I've told you what's in it.
I've seen little bits on the internet.
Yeah, well, no, you shouldn't do that. You shouldn't do that, Dave. I never, ever watch the previews or anything like that. Well, they call them spoilers, don't they?
Oh, right,
spoilers.
Yeah.
I never, ever read. If I'm going to go and see something and I see something written about whatever it's going to be, then I never, ever read spoilers or anything like that. Never.
My other half does. She reads them for a wrestling thing and all that. I said, well, why are you doing that for? Then you don't have to watch it then.
She does what? A wrestling thing?
Yeah.
Is your missus a wrestler? Is she a wrestler?
No, she's not a wrestler, no. God forbid. No.
But, they're not. These wrestlers on the telly, that WWF or whatever it's called, they're not proper wrestlers anyway.
All
staged.
They're actors.
Not like the old wrestlers in the 70s on World of Sports. You know,
anyway,
Mick McManus and...
Because I've got step sports cut calling me.
Eh?
Can you hear that?
Yeah, what is that?
It's Steps' new single.
And what's that doing then?
That's my ringtone.
Is it a phone call? Do you want to go and take a phone call?
Yeah, I better.
All right, Dave. Nice to talk to you, sir.
Yeah, so it's every Saturday now, is it?
What?
Let me talk to Mummy.
Well, we record it every Friday. I record it every Friday morning at 10:30. And this is what we're doing now is making Saturday's show, you see?
Right. Yeah, I've got to make a few shows as soon anyway for the summer.
Did you watch Dallas at all?
I watched the old series when it was on the 80s. I haven't watched this one.
Oh, because the last one was the week before last, and a really good finish off.
CIS and NCIS.
Yeah, they moved it back to 11 o'clock. The viewing figures were disastrous. Absolutely disastrous. They were only getting about 300,000 people watching. So they moved it to 11 o'clock. But I really enjoyed the new series and looking forward to series 3.
Yeah. Yeah, in a minute.
You got your hands full, have you?
Okay, Dad. I'll call you next Friday. No, I'm not here this next Friday, so I'll have to listen to on the Saturday. So.
All right, Dave. Yeah. Nice to talk to you then.
We'll speak to you soon there, Chris.
Cheerio. Bye-bye, care. Dave. Bye-bye. There we are. Dave, who's on the Isle of Wight. And how wonderful to speak to Charlie. That's the little boy. And it's the first time I've actually heard him speak. Now, talking to Charlie, and of course, they're having a new baby, Harry. I'm not quite sure when that's coming. But recently, this week, my nephew and my niece, I call her my niece-in-law. That's my nephew's wife. They have had another baby. Guess what it's called? Another Harry. Harry appears to be a very popular name. Obviously, after Prince Harry, we think, because he's very, very popular, isn't he? I mean, he had that little bit of trouble in Las Vegas, didn't he? Bit naughty in Las Vegas. But perhaps that's what we like about him. He's human. Is that what we like about Harry? He's hugely popular in the States, Prince Harry, isn't he? Did you see him on the telly? Doing sports with various people? Playing with the kids? Doing the football, falling over. He is so popular, Prince Harry. Good luck to him. Because I'm a great fan of the royals. I'm not too keen on all the hangers-on. I like the central royal family. Just a second. Oh, dear. Fag Ash Leo, honestly. One second now. There we are. What was I saying? Yes, I think it's because he's human. And he interacts with everyone, doesn't he? The Americans absolutely love him. And I do like the royal family. But only the ones in the centre. You know, the Queen, Prince Philip, of course. Anne, Charles. I think that's about all, really. And the people related to them, so of course William and Harry. And I think having a royal family does us wonders here in the UK. They bring in an awful lot of money. I've just dropped my pen. They do bring in a lot of tourists. and a lot of money into this country. And you have to get these Republicans, don't they? Oh, why have we got the Queen? It costs us this, that and the other. Believe me, they bring in much, much, much more money than it actually costs us. And the Queen is very frugal. I don't know if you've ever watched when she's wearing these things. You wouldn't see her out with one of those vile £50,000 handbags that Victoria Beckham will walk around with. I think it's... I don't know what it is about people who want to walk around with lots of expensive things hanging off their arms and round their shoulders. I just don't get that at all. You don't see the Queen, you know. She would probably look at something like that and think to herself, oh, no, that's too expensive. I'm not paying that for a handbag. I'm the same myself, although I just want to point out, I don't actually own a handbag, OK? I don't own a handbag. I have bags, but more likely I'm the sort of person that's too far the other way. I don't own any bags. If I want a bag, I'll pop down to the supermarket, buy a pint of milk and get a free carrier bag. That's me. And I think the Queen is a very frugal person. I think she always looks at ways to save money. But I do feel that the royal family bring in an awful lot more money in tourists than it costs us. And quite apart from it, does it matter? Does it matter? Isn't it nice to have the whole world wanting to come here? All these people that come here, a lot from America, to see Buckingham Palace, to see the changing of the guard, to see the castles, the various castles all over the country, Windsor Castle and all that business. All these people are tourists and they pay money when they get here. Not to just walk into the castle. Yeah, they pay the entrance fee. It's all the fares that keep British Airways and the airlines going, the hotels that they book into, the restaurants that they eat out in. How many of those people wouldn't come if we no longer had a royal family? So I do believe. Anyway, we got onto the subject of the royal family because my nephew and my niece-in-law, as I say, have had a new baby and it's called Harry. So welcome to the world, Harry Butler. Yet another child has come, boys and girls. Three of them now, two last year. There's Evie, the toddler, who's just over one now. There's George, the baby, who's about 8 or 9 months. And now there's Harry, three of them. I mean, I'm not being funny, but Christmas is getting more and more expensive, dear. There's those three, George, Evie and Harry. And then there's my two nephews and niece, Gary, Jimmy and Tracy. And then there's my sister Sharon. It's getting more and more expensive at Christmas, dear. We're going to have to make cutbacks. I think I'm going to start making my own presents. What do you reckon? Have you ever made presents for someone? Christmas presents or anything like that? Let me know on the email. Email address chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. As you can see, those of you that watch the show, not everyone watches, a lot of people just listen. The main website for the show, by the way, you can choose whether you want to watch or just download the audio versions. Not much difference, really, except my head bobbing around. The main website for the show is at unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Fag Ash Leal was with us this morning. She's in Hove in Brighton. Nice to hear from you. It's been a while, my dear. It's been a while. Good morning, Fag Ash Leal, who says, congratulations to Gary and Stacey on the new baby. Bless them. Such a happy family. I have a feeling they're going to have a large family. I don't think it's going to stop there. I think they're going to have more and more children, which is fine by me. Uncle Chris will go up there. I've got to go up there. When is it now? Again. Have I written that down somewhere? For the christening. For the christening of Harry. That's the third time I've been in that church now. Unbelievable. So perhaps I should start making Christmas presents. What do you think? Thaggishlil says, please don't give them mugs with your mug on it or it will scar them for life. Oh, do you remember that? We used to give away little United Kingdom talk things. And one of the things, I had some mugs made once with a picture of me on it and the Union Jack, the United Kingdom talk mug. I wonder if people have still got it. Just imagine drinking out of my mouth. I should have done it. Should have done the picture like that. So that my mouth would have been a lovely piece of ceramic. It was. It was a lovely piece of ceramic. Yes. So thank you for that message, Marge. So that's my that's the baby news at the moment. Another child brought into the world, little baby Harry. Eurovision Song Contest. Oh yes, it's tomorrow, boys and girls. This year's Eurovision Song Contest, and representing the United Kingdom is Bonnie Tyler. Absolutely no chance whatsoever. Now, I like Bonnie Tyler. Turn around every time and then I get a little bit and all that business. I'm holding out for a hero. But the Eurovision song, no. Lame is the word we're looking for. Lame. It's not going to win. I wouldn't be surprised if it's in the bottom five again. It's not good. It really isn't. And I don't understand why we're no longer voting. Well, I do. Actually, I do understand. The reason that we aren't asked to vote for our song to represent the UK now is because we didn't vote very well in the years that we were doing it. We kept losing, coming right down the list. So that's why. But last year wasn't good. This year isn't good. Oh, I don't know what's going to happen now. I don't think it's going to come anywhere. Maybe the bottom five. I can't see us doing better than the bottom five. My tip for the top. Russia. I love the Russian ballad song. And also Azerbaijan. I've got to say, there's quite a lot of good songs this... Just a second. Thaggishlil is saying she didn't see the ad on Facebook this morning. Well, it's there. Have you unsubscribed from me by any chance, Thaggishlil? Because if you have, you won't see the posts, dear. Oh, it's hard work this morning. Have a look on my wall, Thaggishlil. It says there, join me this Friday morning from 10:30 for my live talk show. Can you see that, dear? On my wall. Now, if it hasn't come on your wall, you must have changed your setting on there. Or perhaps Facebook has changed the setting. Let me see if I can help you with that one, my dear. Can you see it on my wall now? Thaggishlil's writing us a live Skype message. You can join in by Skype. Don't forget that, boys and girls. If you're watching the show live and it's Friday morning at 20 past 11, then join in by Skype. Skype username is all one word, Chris Reardon, OK? Chris Reardon is the Skype username. I did look once. I realised the time, all I can see is from 9 hours ago. Well, you can't do. It's a... 52 minutes ago, join me this Friday morning. And then an hour ago, join me this Friday morning. And last night, join me this Friday morning. Can you not see all those on my wall? You must have something blocked somewhere if you can't see those. Let me have a look at you all. Let me just see. If I bring someone up. Okay. Right. Let me help you here, Thaggishlil. Bring up my Facebook. Okay, bring up my Facebook. To the right of me, where my picture is, and then it says my name, to the right, there is a little tick where it says friends. Can you see that? Click on that. Click on the friends thing. Now, is there a tick where it says show in newsfeed? is that ticked? Because if it isn't ticked, you won't be able to see my updates. That should be ticked. Show in newsfeed. How can I have blocked you? Don't be silly. What's your Facebook username? Let's have a look. See what's gone wrong. I shall help you here. There it is. Oh, no, Ohio State University. That's not you, is it? I don't think it is anyway. No, I'm sure that's not you. What's your Facebook username, Bagashlil? Do let me know. Oh, that's a him. That can't be you. I'm just typing in something there. Need your username. Come on, Fagashlil. What's your username, darling? Let me know. So, the Eurovision, I can't see us coming anywhere in the top five. I do think Russia, because I quite like a ballad. Now, there are rather a lot of very good songs this year on the Eurovision. I liked the one from Israel. I thought that was pretty good. And Azerbaijan as well. I quite like the one from Azerbaijan. Have you been there? No, I haven't been to Azerbaijan. Thank you. Right, come on, Lil. Let's get this sorted, my darling. Right, let's have a look. What's happened here? L-I... That's it. Assisting people now. There it is. Is this it? Study at Must Tried Hard. No, we're friends. We are friends. Can you not see me, Lily? We're friends already. You've done something which is stopping the updates. Have you got my Facebook page? Can I give you a call? That would be a lot easier. Hang on, it says call phone. No, I can't give you a call, can I? Because you don't have something connected. Huh? Oh dear, this is hard work. Oh, you're hard work this morning, girl. But can let you see my page? Is friends ticked? Let's send her a message. Very strange indeed. Yes, there's a lot of really good ballads on there. I do like a ballad. I like all the Barry Manilow stuff, as you well know. And my tips are Russia and Azerbaijan. I think they might win. I do hope that the UK presentation is as good or better than it was for the two semi-finals. I didn't like Scott Mills. And who was that awful American woman? All the blooming time. She was getting on my nerves. Really getting on my nerves. I don't understand why we had two UK presenters, if you see what I mean, doing that. It didn't make sense to me at all, that. Which is getting on my nerves. Why can't they just show the show as it is? Why do we have to have these two idiots like that? Oh, there we are. 1 second. I think we might be able to take the call now. There we are. Let's go to Fagashlil. Good morning, Fagashlil.
Good evening.
Last. There we are. Now, what are you doing with this face ache?
Well, if your delay wasn't so blinking long, you'd understand my messages.
My what?
Your delay. You must be about 3 hours ahead.
Oh, there's always going to be a delay because of the video, the way it works. By the way, is the picture a little bit jumpy this morning? It was looking a bit jumpy to me.
I don't know, because I've been spending far too much time on your Facebook.
Oh, have you? Right. So you've got my Facebook page up, have you?
It's your Facebook page up, yes.
Right. See, there's a picture right,
I'll start again. I'll go to my homepage, and I'll type in your name at the top.
Yeah? Yeah, okay.
And it says, Chris Reardon, the Mayflower, London Oratory.
Yep. Right, click on that.
Click on that.
So you now have my Facebook homepage.
Yep.
So there's a picture of a sunset in front of you.
Yep.
And on the left, me and three other people with me with a silly hat on.
Yep.
Okay.
And on the right...
Yes?
The last thing I've got is Marge, 11 hours ago. tornadoes.
On the right, at the same level as where that little picture is, and then go across the sunset, there are two boxes. One says friends and one said message.
Right, got friends, yeah.
Right. Is friends ticked?
Yeah, and yeah. Sure, in newsfeed is ticked as well, yes.
Show in newsfeed is ticked?
Yeah.
Then I don't understand why you can't see them. Oh, hang on. No. Show in newsfeed. Okay, click on settings underneath that.
Okay.
What's ticked?
Most updates. So I need all updates.
Tick all updates, yeah.
Thank you.
That's why.
Thank
That's
you.
Why you're not getting it, okay?
I'm sorry for being so stupid.
All right. Now, above it...
Oh, I've got you.
Right above in the address bar, highlight it and just hit enter.
Oh, hang on. I pressed your message thing instead. Oops.
Okay.
Oh, no, I've done it wrong again, haven't I? Blinking technology.
Worry not, my darling. You sound very good today. You've got a new microphone.
Oh, it's my son's expensive one.
Oh, is it? Does he know?
Yeah, well,
does he know you're using his equipment?
He doesn't like me to use it, no.
Shh. So, it's our secret. Yes.
Right, show all updates, yes. I'll click that one, and then what do I do? Sorry.
Right, okay, so you've done that. Now, you see the address bar right at the beginning where it would say facebook.com/ChrisReardonUK.
Yep.
Right? Mm-hmm. Highlight that.
Okay.
And hit enter.
Oh, just highlight it. It's not highlighted, it does itself. Right.
Right?
Yeah. And
right, now, can you see the posts now?
No. I really can't. I'm sorry, Chris.
So what's the last thing you can see?
Marge, talking about tornadoes.
Okay, well, underneath that, can't you see anything?
Yeah, Ross, 13 hours ago.
Well, I don't understand why you can't see this morning's ones.
Hang on a minute. I'll try another name.
We could do with someone else sending us a message, actually, telling us whether or not... they can see it. Because now I'm starting to wonder if anyone can see it.
I don't know, I'm just going to check for you. That's a wonderful thing about having multiple Facebook accounts.
Oh, is that what you've got? Well, that's probably half the bloody problem then, woman.
No, it's not my problem. No, on that one, that still says Marge. And hang on, let me try another one.
Well, I've just done another post. So go back to me if you can see that now.
Oh, I've got to type in me other one. Because this one's more complicated. Dum, dum, dum. Sing to yourself. Come on, you practice your Eurovision song. No, I haven't got anything. I've been in three different accounts. Nothing's updated for me.
Well, I don't understand that then.
It's probably me.
I think it's probably you as well.
Yeah, it's always me. Can I get off the phone yet?
No, not yet. Are you going to watch the Eurovision?
Is it worth it?
There's some really nice songs on there. The actual staging of the thing is very good. Now, I've got to tell you, I'm not a Eurovision fanatic. And then some of those people are just off their heads.
No, dressing up in wild parties and things like that.
I am absolutely off their heads. I watched it. It's nothing wrong with that. You know, it's just really enthusiastic. It's the same as you get Star Trek enthusiasts. And maybe, you know, I consider myself a huge Barry Manilow fan, but not a fanatic.
Well, be careful with them Star Trek fans.
Eh?
Especially be careful with them Star Trek fans,
especially
Star Trek in Norwich.
Fans, yeah. I mean,
or Norfolk.
Yeah.
You see that one?
No. What was that?
Star Trek fans and Doctor Who fans.
Go on.
We were going to have a bit
fight,
of a punch up. Yeah.
Yeah, I saw about that. Yeah, there was a bit of a fight, wasn't there? Good God.
Come on.
So what was all that about?
Because somebody was trying to get somebody's autograph and our two groups don't like each other.
Well, let me tell you, a friend of mine who comes to the quiz night I do in Rotherhithe on Tuesday night, you know, the Mayflower in Rotherhithe.
Yeah.
Just a minute.
I was ringing to complain about the sound of my voice.
It's someone cutting grass outside. I could hear strange noises. She went to the Star Trek convention, which was in London, I don't know, Earls Court or somewhere like that, sometime last year. And she says it was commercialism at its very worst. You know, you paid so much to go in. If you wanted to go into a VIP area, that was more money.
Oh, ridiculous amounts.
If you wanted their autograph, it was like 25 quid.
And you've got a queue for hours to try and get an autograph and pay as well.
If I was a huge celebrity or something like that, I would consider it an honour. They probably get pissed off, you know, signing bits of paper all the time. But I wouldn't have the audacity to charge someone 25 quid for an autograph. I think that's outrageous.
Without these fans, they wouldn't be where they are anyway.
No, that's what I mean.
Yeah, I mean, there was quite a few years ago. Do you remember the series Buffy, the Vampire Slayer?
Yes. I never watched it. A few friends... I mean, what was all that about? It was just some scantily clad, very pretty lady running about.
Well, the kids were quite young at the time. They enjoyed it.
Yeah.
And I think it was... it shows how long ago it was. My daughter's going to be... I don't know how old she is. 28, I think she's going to be this year. Really? 27, 28, one or the other.
Yeah.
I'll work it out before her birthday. I think it was going to be like her 16th birthday, and they had a convention in Brighton.
Yes.
So I looked to take her for a birthday. And I went, how much? And then how much for a VIP? I went, sorry.
So this was a convention for?
Buffy.
Buffy, okay.
Yeah.
How much was it then?
Oh, I can't remember. We were talking at least 100 quid for the VIP thing after you'd already paid for your ticket.
That's a hell of a lot of money just to go and see that.
And I thought, well, no, because, you know, it's for her 16th birthday. Yeah. So I'd have to go with her.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
You're not going to afford double that.
No, no.
And then buy things when you're in there. I said, sorry, love.
It's shocking. It's like some of these concerts that you go to now.
Mm.
You know.
Well, I'm just grateful I saw AC/DC when I saw them many years ago. Because I wouldn't pay. Not that I couldn't afford it necessarily. I just wouldn't pay the ticket prices.
Yeah, so you went to an AC/DC concert?
Oh, I've seen them a few times, yeah.
Fantastic. I wish I'd have gone to see ELO.
Yeah, I like them.
Mr. Blue Sky, Living Thing. I'm going to try Mr. Blue Sky at one of my karaoke nights soon, I've decided. Don't worry, don't hang up yet. I'm not going to give you a rendition today because I haven't practiced it yet. The sun is shining in the sky. Da, 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 da. Love it, love it.
My favourite, I think, is Last Train to London.
Oh, Last Train to London. Don't know that one. I'm just going to write that down. Mm. Was that a hit? Was that a top 10 here, or was it just on an album?
It must have been, because I'm just like about a million years younger than you, so I was too young to be able to go to the concert.
A million years? How old are you now?
47.
Oh, you are a million years younger than me.
Yeah, I am.
I've got gaps in my teeth now and everything.
Hang on, am I 47? Am I 48? I'm not sure.
I am. It looks, unfortunately, when I do that with my teeth, it looks like I've got black bits on the teeth, but it's not, it's gaps.
Yeah, I did notice that not so long ago. I haven't you on this massive TV right in front of me?
I'm not, am I? Oh, that's scary.
Yeah.
Is my
video about 52 inches today, Chris?
I say. I've come over a lot now.
Uh-huh.
Tell me, is the video smooth today? Because it looks a bit jerky today. It's not usually jerky.
It is a bit. It's not as good as it. Yeah, been better.
Yeah, I thought it was jerky. Yeah. I don't know why it's a bit jerky.
52 inches and you're not as good as you normally are.
No, it's the same one because I have a monitor in front of my ear just to check that everything's working all right. And the same thing is here, you know, it's a little bit jerky. But as long as I sound, I'm not so much worried about the picture. It's the sound that I want to.
Well, then you'll have to cut this entire bit out because I'll always sound dreadful.
You sound wonderful, dear.
I love you.
You sound wonderful. Have you heard Marge yet?
I heard her the other week. Yeah. Last week I couldn't because I was trying to organise my son to go away somewhere.
Yeah. Where's he gone?
Last week he went to run around in a field with pretend weapons and things.
Oh, was he that LARPing. LARPing. Eh?
Where they dress in like all sorts of period costumes and run around.
What's it called?
LARPing. LARPING.
Oh, I've never heard of that. Is that like a medieval thing, is it?
Yeah, mostly.
Oh, right, okay.
By the way, I do hope this mute button works every time I burp.
Yeah, I haven't heard you burp yet.
Oh, that's good.
It's when it comes out the other end, it's not very pleasant, dear.
No, you started on that one. But this is why you scared the cats the other week when I joined in.
Why?
Because the way he's got, because we don't watch TV.
Yeah.
The son's taken over the living room for his mega PC and things.
Yes.
But they've got mega TV, mega PC, and a desk right up close in front of the TV.
Oh.
So the cat jumps in, jumps on the desks, desk, takes one look at the screen, and goes, ah, and runs out again.
What, because I'm on there?
Yeah. It's all right.
Oh, cats. I don't believe that. Cats like me. Cats love my mate, Ron. You know he's got five cats, don't you?
Okay, that's... you know, Mad Cat Woman type thing?
Yeah, yeah. Not only has he got five cats, other cats now keep coming to his door.
Yes.
He gets random cats come into the house, mm-hmm. purr, have something to eat, and then leave again. And we reckon the cats talk to each other.
They do,
and
because...
Say, oh, you want to go to that bloke down there. He's got a nice house. He'd give you something to eat. And random cats are now turning up at his door for something to eat.
Well, they it's a case of, you can't have one cat because they get a bit lonely.
Yeah.
You get two cats. That's fine. They've got friends.
Yeah.
And then, as you say, they go out. And because the other cats in the neighbourhood keep seeing them go back to the same house.
Yeah.
They go, oh, must be good there.
Yeah. I think that's exactly what's happening.
I was about a year ago, I was introduced to one of the neighbour's cats when I woke up one morning and she was in bed with me.
Your neighbour's cat?
Yeah, because the kids had been up before me and left the door open to let the cats in and out and things.
Well, you know my cat sleeps with me now, don't you?
Well, this one does all the time.
Yeah, it doesn't surprise me. You remember all that business I had with the asthma and all that?
Yeah.
I don't think it's the cat at all. She's been sleeping with me for months now since she was ill back in December.
Mm. Or it could be something to do with her problem, that now that's been fixed. You're fixed.
Is that possible?
I don't know. Because things transfer between humans and cats.
Yeah, but it was a thyroid thing she had, wasn't it? Now, if I stroke her, then I mustn't touch my eyes. I know that, because they will come up.
Yeah, but that's... Yeah, I mean, that's just the fur thing.
But, you know, you can hear now. There's no problem at all with my... Listen. No problem at all. In fact,
I've got... You the form
you know what I haven't done recently? My asthma blow thing. What is it called?
Inhaler.
No.
Oh, no, the... Oh, those things.
The tester.
Oh, I can't do them because I smoke too much.
Now, you was a nurse, weren't you? What's a good...
I wasn't. I told you last time you died.
What was you?
I was a secretary.
Oh, you know these things. So what's a good result on this?
I can't remember because my kids were tested when they were little and I can't remember.
All right, then.
Well, I just ignore them because I can't blow enough.
Right, here we go, then. You ready?
Connor.
Ready?
Go on, quest.
Ready?
Come.
500.
Well, I don't know, but I'll tell you what, it sounded good. I'll wait till I see it on the screen.
Do
it
again,
good.
Do it again, do it again. Do it again. 500. And they say do three, didn't they? Shall I stand up for
dead.
This one?
Let me
stand
I'd be up for dead if I did three.
Stand up for this one. 500. There we are. So I'm getting 500 on the asthmometer thing.
So, don't forget to tune in next week for Mr. Smug Reardon.
No, so, I don't think it was the cat at all. Or maybe it was. You're quite right, though, that the problem... Mm. The bad... When it was a bit... that hasn't happened since December.
Yeah.
That really hasn't. So there we are.
We are connected with them.
Oh, yeah, I believe that. Yeah. I believe it. Sometimes I'm at work and I feel to myself that she wants me to come home. I think, oh, the cat wants me to come home. Do you think she could will me to come back?
Oh, yeah. Feed me.
No, no, it's not a feed. Because there's always food down, you see. There's always food down there,
Have you given her any cat crack yet? We call it cat crack in our house.
Oh, catnip?
No, Whiskers cat treats.
Oh, no, she has dreamies, I think they're called. She likes dreamies. It was quite funny the other day. My mate Ron, he was downstairs and we got a couple of bags of Maltesers because there were two for one or something like that. I can't remember what it was now. Yeah. And he opened this packet. Cat was down there, opened the packet. Immediately, meow, meow, meow. It sounded like a packet of cat treats. She was doing her nut. Meow.
The neighbour's cat's the worst because I opened a packet of feathers and she's trying to get them out. You know, I said, no, they're not cat treats.
Open the packet of fags.
Yeah. So you open the cat treats for her. And she does, she gets a paw in there. And she's purring, doing her claws everywhere. And gimme, gimme, and trying to knock them out your hand. She goes ballistic over them.
Since she had that illness, she follows me around a lot now. If I'm in the living room, she'll jump. If I'm having my dinner on the... Because I don't sit at the table for dinner. I don't know about you.
Well, there's not a lot of point when you're on your own, is there?
No, no. So a tray comes out, goes on your lap. You know how it is. She will jump on the footstool in front of me,
yeah,
or the settee next to me, and sit down and wait. She will wait. And the moment I take the tray off the lap, she's over to sit down on my lap. Very, very close. And she follows me around. If I go out in the garden, do a bit of gardening, she'll come out there. Whatever. Follows me around.
How old is she now?
14 or 15.
Yeah, just a couple of years older than mine then.
Very close. Sleeps a lot now as well. Sleeps a lot.
Yeah. My youngest one, I think he's 12.
I think she's curled up 22 hours a day.
Mm. That's my youngest one. He's 12, but then he's got a bit of a dodgy heart because he got ill.
Oh, is he?
What a few wrong? Years back.
What happened to him?
Well, I don't know. He was fine, running around, causing trouble like he usually does.
Yeah.
He went to bed one day, and I looked at him, and he just like, And you know that other eyelid that they've got?
Yes, yes.
It was closing right over both eyes.
Oh, so he couldn't see.
So we dashed him off down the vets.
Right.
And they did a scan on him and everything. Ultrasound scan on him, everything. Looked brilliant.
Oh.
And just said, oh, no, he's got a heart disease.
Ah.
So well, they said looking, he needs his pills for the rest eyes. Of his life, every day.
Is that by looking at his eyes they could tell that?
No. So they did an ultrasound test of his heart.
Oh, that's expensive, that is. Have you got the pet insurance, have you?
No, because I'm cheap. I got PDSA and they did that for me.
Oh, okay. Because when she went in, they suggested before the operation we could try an ultrasound test, and it was 300 quid.
That's why I love the PDSA, well, and you give them all the money that you can, right. You know?
Well, I didn't have it done because I had the operation anyway, but I spent quite a lot of money on her around Christmas, as you well know, but it doesn't matter, you know.
Well, I'm saying, I mean, I'm quite happy to give the money, any extra money I've got to the PDSA.
Right, yeah. Is that for anyone, the PDSA?
Low-income people.
Right, okay. Okay.
Yeah. And you have to live in specific areas near where they are, yes, and things like that. But they were absolutely fantastic. But they said he needed heart pills for the rest of his life.
Right.
I don't know about you. Have you ever tried giving cats pills?
Yes, because she had before the thyroid operation, she had these little pills. It became easier, to be honest. I think she got to the point where she expected it.
No, he even if we wrapped it up in tuna and things like that, he wouldn't.
Oh,
it
no, no,
just
no.
Fight.
You kind of put your arm around her legs so she can't move. And with the other two fingers, you put those in her mouth so it opens.
Yep.
And you push it back as far as you can and it goes straight down. You literally push your finger into her mouth.
Maybe I know how to do it, but it used to take two of us to hold him to be able to do it.
Maybe as far as the first or second knuckle. And indeed, after the operation, because she didn't recover very well, so we had to give I had to give calcium tablets. They were big. They were big, and when I looked at them, I thought, well, I'm going to have to chop those up.
Yeah.
The trouble is, when you chop a tablet up, it then has sharp edges.
Mm, true.
So I asked the vet, he says, no, just give it to a hole. I said, how am I going to get that down her throat?
Yeah.
He said, push it down. He said, look, I'll do one for you. And you literally do. So I had this tablet, which looked bigger than her mouth, right? Put it on her tongue and push it right, and you can feel it go down. Feel it go down, and it became easier as time went along, to be honest.
Well, I'm not very good at that.
Oh, well, practice.
Well, we gave up with him in the end because it was just so difficult to give him in.
Yeah, oh, well.
Anyway, this is like 2 years ago, 3 years ago, and he's still been found without them. He sleeps a lot more now.
You've not been giving them to him then?
No, he just sleeps a lot more instead.
Okay, well, fair enough.
I thought, well, you know, it came because he ran out of something.
Yeah.
And there was nobody available to take him to the vets again to get repeat ones because they wanted, you know, they always want to see them.
Poor little thing.
And I said, well, is there any point? Because he's, at that stage, he was back to his normal self.
Yeah.
Running around.
Yeah.
You know, up and down, chasing all the neighbours' cats, killing baby birds, all that sort of thing.
Stupid birds shouldn't land in the garden, should they?
Well, no. Oh, they did that once. They brought this tiny little baby bird in.
baby boy, baby boy.
And I kept it until it died. It didn't shout at me just before it died in my hands.
Don't make me cry. Don't make me cry.
No.
Poor little bird.
Oh, yes. Talking about things like that and animals. You're not really going to go vegan, are you?
Well, I've been going that way, to be honest.
But what about eggs? Please don't give up eggs.
It's very, very difficult. Let me tell you that. You've got to read everything on the packet. Okay, so vegetarian now. I'll be coming up to 2 or 3 years.
Yeah.
I think I'm in my second year of being vegetarian now. Most dairy products have gone. There's still a bit of cheese in there. I've tried cheese alternatives.
They will improve in time.
I wish they would.
Yeah. I couldn't give up my cheese.
Not that nice. They certainly don't melt the same. If you put them on a burger or something like that, they don't melt the same at all. Some of them have got a really vile taste to them, vegan cheese. Some of it is acceptable. So I'm trying to find some. I don't drink milk anymore. Unless I'm in a cafe, you know, they don't have soya milk in places, very rarely.
A lot of places do these days.
Do they?
You just got to ask.
Okay. Well, that's worth doing then. But I certainly don't. I don't buy any milk now because I looked into the dairy industry, and that's particularly cruel.
I was going to say, if you don't ask,
yeah,
and rather if you do ask, and you get enough people asking, then they'll start stocking it, won't they?
Yeah. So the dairy products are gone. I don't buy any cream, anything like that. The only thing is, like, you know, again, you've got to be so careful because I quite like tomato soup.
Yeah.
You know, you can get tomato and basil soup. But you've got to be careful that they haven't added cream. A lot of them has had cream added, or cream of mushroom soup. Now, I like that, but I don't want to be supporting the cruelty that's done to animals in this highly mechanised world of ours. It's mechanical.
Although I still do eat meat, not an awful lot of it.
Yeah.
My youngest one is the only one who lives at home with me now, and he's vegetarian.
Oh, right, okay, yeah.
So he's been vegetarian longer than you.
How old is he?
How old is he? 21 this year.
Okay. And actually, when you look on the internet, I find more and more recipes where you can make all your own vegetables. Some really lovely mess. I make a wicked chili out of corn stuff. But actually, you don't even need the corn. You know,
you can't beat corn, though, can you? You have to be careful with corn, though, because if you do go vegan, some of their products do actually contain egg.
Oh, do they? Mm. Yeah, as I say, going back to the whole vegan thing, you know, eggs. And believe it or not, honey. You're not supposed to have honey either.
I can sort of see it. But then you've got to be careful because things like salt powder and conditioner and things like that.
Oh, it all
Because they contain animal scales and things.
So, you know, it's not as easy as just doing it, you know.
You've got
to be so careful with the bits and pieces.
But please don't give up eggs, because when you do eventually... Once I eventually move and you come to see me for a cup of tea...
Yeah.
With soy eggs. Milk or whatever. So if you tell me which brand you like, then I've got to make you some cake. I can't not make you cake.
Well, there is the birthday cake, isn't there?
You're not going to come down for another year? The one you ate for your birthday?
Birthday cake has got eggs in it, I suppose, isn't it? Can you not make cake without eggs?
You can, but they don't work so well. But I've got this wonderful recipe for a beetroot cake.
All right, yeah.
It uses oil instead of butter or margarine.
Okay.
And the only thing it's got in it that you can't have is eggs.
Oh, well.
Oh, well, have you switched sneeze. Yourself off or did they switch
Where's
you off?
Where's the tissue?
Did you switch us off?
Excuse me. What?
Bless you. Did you switch us off?
No.
Because I've just got an error occurred.
You've Bless just what?
You. Hang on. Let me just refresh.
What have you done?
Oh, no, it's all right. You're back. No, it just went off. It said, error occurred. Please try again later on the YouTube. But it's back again now.
Oh, okay. Right, I've got to get through some emails now before
yes,
we finish.
Yes, you do. And I'm
nice
going
to
go
talk
on.
To you.
Yeah. You take care.
Thank you, Ashley. We love you. Nice to see you. So remember that. Live every Friday morning, 10:30, all right?
Yeah, right. Just send me messages. Okay. Because you
all
know
right,
what?
Neil.
Rubbish I am.
See, just refresh that Facebook again now and see if you see
You're
it.
Determined, aren't you?
Just once more before you go. Because I'm pretty convinced that that's on there somewhere.
I'm sure it is somewhere, but not for me. Now, all I've got is Marge Spirit Dove says Dallas, Texas almost got it.
Do you know the refresh button?
Yeah, I just did it.
F5 or whatever it is.
No, it's got a little swirly thing in the corner with an arrow.
Well, I don't know why you can't see it.
Because I'm pants. And on that note, I shall leave you.
Thank you, Marge. Nice to talk to you.
Will you stop calling me Marge?
Oh, yeah. Fag Ashley.
Oh, yeah. The other one. All right.
Fag Ashley. The other one.
Yeah. What a love.
It's just Bye. The two. Just the two. See you, Leo.
See ya.
Fag Ashley in Hove. Lovely part of the world. It's the better part of Brighton, actually. All right, then. Some emails to do, boys and girls. Hello to Ross Pats Out, who rarely writes now, boys and girls. He sent me a picture yesterday of someone else who does a podcast, a video podcast type thing like this, and he's built the shed in the garden, and it's all very high-tech inside the shed and all. And he said, you should get one of these. I don't need one of those, Ross. I don't need to build anything in the garden. I've got a house here with two spare rooms. I'm in comfy in my spare room, thank you very much. Nice thought, though. Nice thought. That lad looks like he's spent a lot of money on that. I hope he's got security there. That would worry me, having all sorts of equipment in a shed in the garden, wouldn't it, you? And what about damp and things? And of course, you've got the extra heating then as well, haven't you, in the shed? Cost you an arm and a leg. Ross says on the subject of last week's show, it's James Dean. I thought it was dead. No, only his career. It's just the career that's dead, Ross. Not him himself. Although, looking at him, I thought he was a little bit dead as well, to be as dead in the water. Hello to C... We've upset someone, boys and girls. We've upset someone. Hello to CW, who writes, G'day, Chris. It's Chris from Victoria, Australia here. Hello, sir. Well, it's been a very long time, dear. I was listening to your show on the 11th of the 5th. And shock horror, when asked if I believe Marge in Oklahoma, if anyone has listened since episode 1, and you replied, one person, but she doesn't come on anymore. Yikes, mate. I've listened since episode 1 in the old Live 365 days. I remember those. That's a wonderful little service, Live 365, although I think it's quite been surpassed by lots of other technology, like Shoutcast and YouTube, indeed, because YouTube, I don't think YouTube and Google Plus, none of these things were around, were they, when Live 365 was first on? Sorry I don't write like I once did, but I do still listen to every podcast wherever I am in the world at the time, as I do travel quite often. Also, I found it quite funny and ironic about your new chair you bought after someone brought up the fact that you had a leather one and it broke straight away. Well, it did. I couldn't believe that. Was it... What was his name? Someone was complaining because I go on about the vegetarian thing and all that business. And he said, isn't that a leather chair? And I said, yes. And I said, well, I'm not going to replace it. I've had it 13 years. I'll replace it when it breaks. Well, blow me down. A week later... It broke after all that time. Isn't that weird? hope you don't tempt fate with your new one. Always a faithful listener, Chris from Victoria, Australia. Sorry, Chris. I knew someone would be there. I knew someone would be there to correct me. We do like a bit of correction. Would be there to correct me for that. So I do apologise. Chris in Victoria, Australia has been with us since day one, which is nearly 7 years ago now, isn't it? 7 years I've been sitting here chatting away. Unbelievable. Hello to the lovely Wendy. Hello, Wendy. And a fellow fan, hello, who writes on the subject of cat decloring. Hi, Chris. Have been meaning to write to you about the subject of cat decloring for a couple of days and have only just had a chance. I have very strong thoughts and feelings on this, and these are the reasons I think cat declawing is cruel. Now, I've already said to you, I too think it's a pretty cruel thing to declaw a cat. You know, it's just, why would you want to do that? Cat declawing is an extremely painful procedure, which makes a lot of sense when you think about what declawing involves. It isn't just removing your cat's claws, The front of each of their toes is amputated at the joints. Can you imagine someone coming up to you and asking if they could cut off the tips of all your fingers and thumbs? Well, that is what cat declawing is. A cat experiencing multiple amputations all at once. Recovery from declawing is also a very slow process and very painful for the cat. I mean, I don't like it at all. I mean, we're doing that for us, really, aren't we? You know, we are actually doing something for us. Not the cat. Doesn't benefit the cat at all. And I think it's a cruel thing. Wendy says cats use their claws to defend themselves. If a cat spends any time outside, there are dangers they will need to be able to protect themselves from. Like the dog one of your neighbours let roam free throughout the neighbourhood. Or indeed, other cats. Having claws gives your cat a fighting chance. Without claws, they have no chance at all. You could keep a cat declawed in the house all hours of the day and night, but there's a good chance the cat wouldn't be very happy. Well, I know that. I mean, Ron, before he moved into a place with a garden, he lived in a flat and he had two cats. And I just didn't think they were happy, stuck in the flat all the time. I think a cat needs to roam free, don't you? I think it's asking it a bit too much for it to be stuck in a house all day long. It doesn't matter how many toys you bring them. It just doesn't seem right to me. Wendy says there are alternatives out there, such as nail caps that don't cause any pain, and of course, scratching posts. Oh, what's that there? It's another phone ringing. And she says, thought you might like to see this picture below. Beauty was one of our cats who was a cream Persian. She was only a kitten here, cute. Sadly, we lost her a few years ago. And there's a little picture there, although it's a little bit difficult to see on the old black and white thing. It's a black and white. I don't print anything in colour. Costs too much, Wendy. So thank you very much for that, Wendy. And we're in total agreement with this. And she found a link for us, top reasons not to declaw a cat, which I've read through. And I think it's an unnecessary, cruel thing to declaw a cat. I really do. And finally today, just one more email today from James. Hello, James. Who writes, hi, Chris. Hope you're okay. Yes, thank you very much. I hope the one show a week works out for you. Well, it's for the summer. It's for the summer. We did the same thing last year. I completely stopped for the summer. I just completely stopped for the summer. And we came back again a little bit later on. I don't blame you, as I hope we have a nice summer on its way, although it's a bit cold at the moment again, isn't it? As the weather seems quite nice so far. Well, it was until sort of last Monday, and it got cold again. You were talking about customer services in shops like HMV was one of them, that they were very good at customer service, as it's a shame the one where I am is disappearing, as they offered help if you weren't sure on a product or just needed assistance in general. I guess this is the way now. Oh, yes. We've lost our HMV in Bracknell as well. It went a couple of months ago. It was disappointing. I've got to be honest, you know, I didn't go in there all the time buying stuff constantly. I went in there a lot to browse. Just had a little look what was in there. But apart from that, you know, no. Customer service seems to be a problem in general now, and it seems rather a shame. Well, it depends what shop you go in, James. I mean, it really does depend what shop you're in. You know, to work the customer services in. I've always said to you, John Lewis is the best customer service ever. John Lewis, very, very good customer service. And I went to Staples. Staples, which where I bought this lovely new chair from, which is not going to break. Although it's not, I've got to say, it's not as good as the other one. Now it won't, sometimes it doesn't always go back. It's not doing it now. It doesn't always go back, but I'm kind of putting up with it. You are quite upright in this, and I don't think I move about so much on this. Where's my tissue gone? I really want to blow my nose. Yeah. Fagashlil says, cats need to go out and de-clawing is wrong. I totally agree with you. The only reason you declaw a cat is for your benefit. What about the benefit of the animal? Why don't we think about the animal so much? Your thoughts on that, please, on email, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Right, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Right, Fagashlil, just to let you know, your little thing has come up on the Facebook, so that's cool. I can see that. Hopefully you'll be able to see my post. Keep an eye on that during the week, because you know I do quite a lot of posts, and see that that's coming up, otherwise there's something wrong somewhere. Hello to Saltwater 102, who says, show us pictures of the garden. Ah, well, I can't, because there's no camera out there, unfortunately. And as we're doing a live show, there's only the one camera in front of me. I can't show pictures of the garden. Sorry about that, sir. Anyway, that's it for now, boys and girls. Thank you very much for joining us this week. Okay, now, if you want to join the show live, then we are on every Friday morning at 10:30. So we record Saturday's show on Friday morning at 10:30 UK time. That's 10:30 BST. And I think that's 9:30 GMT, boys and girls, because we're in British summertime at the moment. British summertime, 10:30 UK time every Friday morning. Where can you find it? Simply go to unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. At the top there, you will see the link to where the live show is on Friday mornings at 10:30. Meanwhile, between now and then, if you're watching a recording on the show, it'd be lovely to hear from you by email. The email address is chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Right, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. If you want to come and play karaoke and you're in the London area, I'm doing karaoke tomorrow. That's Saturday, the 18th of May, at the Laurel Tree Public House in Hammersmith. That's a lovely place it is. It's also someone's birthday tomorrow, Dwayne, who's a bit of a singer, and he kind of comes around to all the karaoke nights. Let me just have a cough. Okay, that's the Lorry Arms. Did I say the Laurel Tree? No, completely wrong. The Lorry Arms in Hammersmith on Saturday night between 9 p.m. and 1 a.m. Okay? So that's Saturday, the 18th of May, 2013. The Lorry Arms in Hammersmith on Shepherd's Bush Road, quite near to the tube station. Join us for that. That's free entry. And also, Sunday night, we do karaoke at Belushi's in Camden High Street, number 50 Camden High Street. And that's Sunday nights between 8 p.m. and midnight. That one's also free. Thank you very much for watching and listening. Don't forget, drop in your emails, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Whatever you're doing this weekend, have a wonderful time. Thanks for watching and listening.